Now we go to the next problem. And here the type of beam is simply supported beam with UDL. So here we have to convert this UDL into point load. So to convert this, I will multiply this UDL value, that is 2 kN per meter, with the length over which the UDL act, that is 4 meter. And this converted point load act on midpoint of length over which UDL acts, that is half of 4 meter, which is 2 meter. Now this type of problem we are going to solve in 3 steps. Here the first step is to calculate values of support reaction. And the first condition is summation Fy is equal to 0, where upward forces treated as positive and downward forces treated as negative. So I can write this as Ra plus Rb minus 5 minus 8 is equal to 0. Therefore Ra plus Rb is equal to 13. So here I will give this as equation number 1. Now the second equation of equilibrium, that is summation of moment. And here my sign convention would be clockwise movement as positive and anti-clockwise movement as negative. So therefore if I am taking movement at point A, I fix beam at point A. And here 5 kN load will be pushing this beam towards downward. So it rotates beam clockwise, that is plus 5 kN. Now as per decided, movement is always force into distance from fixed point. So plus 5 kN is the force into 5 meter is the distance from fixed point. Now 8 kN load will be pushing this beam towards downward. So it rotates beam clockwise, that is plus 8 kN. And here movement is force into distance from fixed point. So plus 8 kN is the force into 2 meter is the distance from fixed point. Now here reaction force Rb will be pushing this beam towards upward. So beam rotate anticlockwise from fixed point. And for anticlockwise rotation, I take it as negative and multiply this force by distance, which is 7 meter from fixed point. So these are the movement which we have. So therefore by calculating this, I will get the answer of Rb as 5.86 kN. Now I put this value of Rb in equation number 1. I will get the value of Ra as 7.14 kN. So here I have calculated values of support reaction, that is Ra as 7.14 kN and Rb as 5.86 kN. Now the step number 2 is shear force calculation. So here the sign convention is upward forces treated as positive and downward forces treated as negative. And here we start shear force calculation from left hand side. So first to calculate shear force at point A, so I will take the section to the left of point A, that is SF at A to the left. And there are no forces on left hand side of this section. Therefore SF at A to the left is equal to 0. So to draw shear force diagram, I will draw horizontal reference line of 0 kN shear force. So here I mark 0 value on reference line. Now if I go to the section to the right of A, that is SF at A to the right, then there is upward force, that is reaction force Ra, which is 7.14 kN. So as per the sign convention, upward forces is treated as positive. So here the shear force is plus 7.14 kN. Therefore SF at A to the right is equal to plus 7.14 kN. And in this case, value of shear force at point A to the right is positive. Therefore, I make vertical line of 7.14 kN. Now I'm taking section to the left of point C, that is SF at C to the left. And here I carry forward previous value of shear force up to point C to its left side, which is 7.14 kN. And to the left side of point C, there is 8 kN downward force, which is negative. So this will be plus 7.14 minus 8. And it gives me the value of shear force as minus 0.86 kN. And in this case, value of shear force at point C to the right is negative. But here this is a uniform distributed load over length of 4 meter. Therefore, I make inclined line of minus 0.86 kN to the point which is below the reference line because shear force value is negative. Now I'm taking section to the right of point C, that is SF at C to the right. And here I carry forward previous value of shear force up to point C to its left side, which is minus 0.86 kN. To the right of point C, there is no force. Therefore, shear force remains constant. That is, shear force at point C to the right is equal to minus 0.86 kN. Now I am taking section to the left of point D, that is SF at D to the left. Then there is no load on beam between point C to point D to its left side. Therefore, shear force value remains constant. That is, shear force value at point D to the left is equal to minus 0.86 kN. Now there is no variation in shear force value, so make the horizontal line with shear force value as minus 0.86 kN. Now I am taking section to the right of point D, that is SF at D to the right, and I carry forward previous value of shear force up to point D to its left side, which is -0.86 kN, and when we move towards right of point D, then there is 5 kN downward force which is negative. So this will be -0.86 - 5, and it gives me the value of shear force as -5.86 kN. Therefore SF at D to the right is equal to -5.86 kN, and in this case value of shear force at point D to the right is negative. Therefore I make vertical line of -5.86 kN to the point which is below the reference line because shear force value is negative. Now when I am taking section to the left of point B, that is SF at B to the left, then there is no load on beam between point D to point B to its left side. Therefore shear force remains constant, that is shear force at point B to the left is equal to -5.86 kN. Now there is no variation in shear force value, so make horizontal line with shear force value as -5.86 kN. Now when I am taking section to the right of point B, that is SF at B to the right, and I carry forward previous value of shear force up to point B to its left side, which is -5.86 kN, and when we move towards right of point B, then there is 5.86 kN upward force which is positive. So this will be -5.86 + 5.86, and it gives me the value of shear force as 0 kN. So here I mark 0 value on reference line, and here in shear force diagram, whatever the portion drawn above the reference line, I will show this by plus sign, and the portion drawn below the reference line, I will show this by minus sign. So here I have completed shear force diagram. Now the next step is calculation of bending moment. So whenever you solve the problem, you should remember these conditions. And here for simply supported beam, the condition is at the end of beam, bending moment will be 0. So bending moment at point A and at point B will be 0. Now here, where shear force value changes from positive to negative, then at that point, the bending moment value is maximum. So I represent this with point E. Now at point E, we have to find out bending moment, but here we don't know location of point E, that is we don't know distance X. But here distance AC is 4 meter, and here value of shear force we consider as height of triangle. For first triangle, the height is 7.14 and base is X. And for second triangle, the height is 0.86 and the base is 4 - X. Therefore, from similarity of triangles, the height of first triangle, that is 7.14 divided by base of first triangle, which is X, is equal to the height of second triangle, that is 0.86 divided by base of second triangle, which is 4 - X. Therefore, by calculating this equation, I will get value of X as 3.57 meter. So here I got the location of point E. So from distance X, now I calculate bending moment at point E. So to calculate bending moment at point E, I will start from left side. And to the left side, there are two forces, that is reaction force RA and UDL force. So here reaction force RA, that is 7.14 kN, which is upward force. And due to this upward force, the effect on beam is sagging effect. And for sagging effect, our sign convention is positive sign. And multiply this with distance from point of action of force, that is 3.57 meter. Now second force is UDL force. So to convert UDL force into point load, here I multiply UDL value into distance. Therefore 2 multiplied by 3.57 is the force. And this is downward force. And due to this force, the effect on beam is hogging effect. And for hogging effect, our sign convention is negative sign. So the force is 2 into 3.57 multiplied by distance from point of action of force, that is half of 3.57 meter, that is 3.57 divided by 2. So the value of bending moment at point E is 12.75 kN meter. So here the value of bending moment is positive, therefore I mark 12.56 kN meter above the horizontal reference line of bending moment diagram. To calculate bending moment at point C, you can start either from left end or right end of beam. Here I will start from left side, and to the left side there are two forces, that is reaction force RA and UDL force, which I convert into point load. So reaction force RA, which is 7.14 kN upward force, and due to this upward force, effect on beam is sagging effect, and for sagging effect our sign convention is plus sign, and multiply this with distance from point of action of force. Now second force is UDL force, which I converted into point load of 8 kN, and this is downward force, and due to this force the effect on beam is hogging effect, and for hogging effect our sign convention is negative sign into distance from point of action of force. So the value of bending moment at point C is 12.56 kN meter. So I will mark 12.56 kN meter above the horizontal reference line of bending moment diagram. Now to calculate bending moment at point D, you can start either from left end or right end of beam. Here I will start from right side because there is only one force, that is 5.86 kN, which is an upward force, and due to this force the effect on beam is hogging effect. And for hogging effect our sign convention is positive sign into distance from point of action of force, that is 2 m. So the value of bending moment at point D is 11.72 kN. So I will mark 11.72 kN above the horizontal reference line of bending moment diagram. Now since I can see this bending moment diagram is drawn above the reference line, so whatever I have drawn, all the values of bending moment is positive, so I will show this portion by plus sign. So here we have completed shear force and bending moment diagram for simply supported beam with UDL.